Hello comrades, it's me, and today we are trying something new. You see, now that we have hit 250,000 subscribers, thanks to you, I thought it may be a good time to try introducing a little variety to my channel by, well, chances are that if you are watching my channel, then you are not just fan of LEGO Technic, but also fan of vehicles of all kinds, stuff that drives. So in this creatively named video series, I'm going to drive things. Things such as this T-55 Soviet medium battle tank. It may not look like much, but this is actually the most produced tank in history, with an estimated between 86 and 100,000 units built. What made the T-55 so popular? It was the fact that it followed the same design philosophy as the legendary T-34 did. It was cheap to make and maintain, easy to produce in large numbers, and offer excellent balance of firepower, protection and mobility for the price. Introduced in 1958, it served with the Russian army up until 2012, and it's still being used by no less than 50 countries around the globe. The T-55 was created with one goal: to replace the aging T-34 as the Soviet army primary tank. It effectively replaced heavy tanks as well, because it proved better and way cheaper than, for example, the famous IS-3 tank. At the time of its introduction, it was considered equal or better than the US M48 Patton and the British Centurion tanks, while again being considerably cheaper and smaller. In fact, the small size was one of the main design principles here. This is a fully fledged main battle tank, and it only weighs 36 tons. Although it's pretty simple, it comes with a number of sophisticated features, such as the automated NBC protection system, wet ammo storage, night vision equipment, and a special cold weather engine startup system. And in case you wonder, this is the cold weather engine startup system. It literally starts fire under the engine, because if it's insane but it works, then it's not insane, right? The tank is operated by a crew of 4, a driver, a commander, a gunner and a loader. Its small size comes at the expense of interior space and ergonomics. In fact, it has prompted the Soviet Army to introduce height limits for soldiers joining the armored units. I'm above the average height and I had a really, really hard time squeezing myself into the driver's seat. The tank is actually quite easy to drive. You can see the driver's main controls right here. Interestingly, each track lever has three positions: full speed, half speed, and stop. There is no proportional speed control, and you can't adjust the turning radius. As for the driving experience, first let me repeat that this tank feels extremely cramped. When driving with the hatch open, you have armor coming up close to your face and you can't really look inside the driver's compartment. On the funny side, the driver enjoys the lowest noise level of all crew members because he's so far away from the noisy engine. I was told that most of the noise actually comes from the engine cooling system rather than the engine itself. So how does it feel to drive the T-55? Scary at first, and then it's very different from driving a car. Without the steering wheel, there's nothing connecting you with the wheels, so you don't really feel the bumps. In fact, the tank seems to kind of float over obstacles thanks to the tracked suspension. It also seems to climb up and down effortlessly, much easier than a car would. In fact, it feels pretty much unstoppable. As a driver, you have to remember that most of the tank is behind you and to your right. It's also advised to keep an eye on the main gun to make sure it's not breaking the trees or something. For much of the time it feels like you're sitting inside a very noisy hovercraft, except that it totally destroys the ground it's driving on. I owe big thanks to the Panzer Farm for letting me drive one of the many tanks in their collection. Check the link in the video description if you'd like to drive one too. And thank you for watching this video, please share and watch again because the number you put under this video will determine whether or not I get to drive more things. Your views matter, and thanks to your views, the T-55 can be just the beginning.